Welcome back to Let's Play Shadow Arts 2. There was supposed to be a part in the last part, or the parts before it, where I attacked the Sun, but I put the crest in the Palace of Transcendence. Basically, all those guys, when you put them in, they get extra crests. Like, one of them has Rock Crest. You put them in the right, all in the right thing, you get Gale Crest. So, they all get an extra crest. So I will just show you where they are. Astaroth's up there. Asmodeus is there. Amon's down there. Ouroboros is there. Gap is there. And Baal says his castle lies at the center of the palace, who is pretty much easy to place. Also, there is one more dude I need to place, which is in the Forsaken Hill, which is Paimon, which goes right there. Dark Resist, blah, 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 blah. It really doesn't matter. But with this, all the ones that belong in Solomon's Key are now put in. So, we get a little scene here with some symbols. And we hear a voice, which is actually King Solomon. This is actually like the third recording of this. Mostly because of the fact of, well, the first time I recorded it, I ended up, after finishing editing it, it came out to like 45 minutes, and I was like, that's too long. I'm like, there's nothing I can really subtract from it. Also, I got a new TV, yay, which is a little bit strange playing it, because I don't know if it's the fact that the fuzziness is gone, or the fact that maybe the TV, when the input goes into the TV, it takes a little longer for it to show up, but the timing on the things are a little bit different, so there might be some fail for a while. Right now, though, what we want to do is go back to Inagami Village, because I'm actually missing a Silver Angel for that. I'm supposed to have 5, and I kept thinking that the last one was from a trial, because my brain read it and went, oh, it's a trial, I haven't done that yet. No, I have that one already. The one I was missing is right over here behind this, thing. And the strange thing is, when I was just right about here in the game, when I first got to Inagami Village, I went over to the friend's house with the copy of the game, because he said he wanted to show me some of the stuff that's at the end, like as far as abilities and whatnot. And that's one of the ones I mentioned to him. He's like, I'm missing some of the Silver Angels. I'm like, there's one in Inagami Village behind the rack. He's like, really? I'm like, yeah, go over there. He was like, oh, look at that. He also missed the one on top of the Petrograd Winter Palace. So, yeah. It's kind of strange that the one I mentioned to him is the one I missed in the game. I feel kind of dumb. I have to admit, I feel kind of dumb. Now that we have all of those, we should go back to Petrograd and talk to, Edgar. Because now that we have all 5 of those, he's going to give us a present. Well, according to him, he's already been preparing it, but he's only going to actually give it to us if we give him all 5 Silver Angels, which, you know, it's, we give it to him, but we still have it in our inventory, probably. Another thing I need to do is make sure that I equip Anastasia, one of the reasons why, I'll do that after. One of the reasons that the first take of this came out to like 45 minutes was the fact that I forgot to equip her, and I had to do all this all over again. And even after cutting out all the stuff that I already done, I forgot to do something else, so I had to start over again. And even cutting out all kinds of stuff, it still came out way too long. Anyways, let's talk to Edgar and see what he's up to. He looks kind of tired. Oh. Also, another thing that happened during the last recording, I was mentioning something about my monitor turning on and off, I'm like, I hope that's not going to break, and then it turned on and stayed on for like 2-3 hours. And then I went out, came back home, turned my computer back on, and the thing just on off, and then it stayed off. And I turned it back on and shut back off, so, you know, I ended up having to get a new monitor, too. Luckily, at least the TV, half of it was a present, So I only really paid for half of it. So basically, in the end, what I did was I bought the TV and I got the monitor for free. At least as long as in my mind it goes. And for some reason, he's very interested in these little pieces of paper. For the legendary... what? Let's see, what else happened since I've recorded last? I think that's about it. As far as, you know, important stuff goes. And he seems to be hiding something. Really? Seriously, big time. Yeah, sure, why not? I won't give them back to you, even if you beg. Alright, here. The legendary can? I don't get it. I have no idea what he's talking about. If can is a euphemism for something, that would make some sense. But otherwise, I have no idea what he's talking about. Yeah, I don't know, something's not right, but in the end, we get Anastasia's ultimate weapon, and, yeah, look at her special attack. I could probably actually end up giving her, I'm actually taking the panoramic lens off. I could probably end up giving her, whatever the item is that increases special damage. Granted, you know, if you read these, it's also received. But 90% of the time, you're given, like the physical attack ones that I gave to Karando and Yuri, they have really high physical defense, so you really don't notice it anyway. And I could give this to her, and I probably wouldn't notice the damage input increase. So, anyways, we want to give her a Meteor Mask for extra physical defense and magical defense. Actually, I'd be better off with the, panties, wouldn't I? Yeah, because her special defense is satisfactory anyways. Is that all I wanted to do? I re-equipped her, which I forgot to win the last time I tried to... Well, one of the last... The other time I tried to record this and I scrapped it was because I was so damn tired and I was going the whole time and mumbling. I can't stand people who mumble. It drives me nuts. Like, if someone says something to me and they're mumbling, I usually just disregard it as not important, because if you can't say it to me clearly, it's not worth me hearing. Maybe I'm just a jerk. Maybe, you know... Because my parents were, you know, whenever I mumbled, I got in deep crap if I mumbled growing up. So, I very rarely mumble. Maybe once in a while I say something under my breath on this, but usually I don't mumble. Maybe some of my older parts are counted as mumbling because I wasn't really sure how to... Well, my commentary's gotten a lot better over the past year, but... Anyway, moving on. Well, we've done all these. I've spent a lot of the time doing this. We got Embodiment Level 1, which is one person, six battles. I'm going to bring Anastasia for photo things. There's only like two things I actually need to take a photo of anyway, so it's not a big deal. And there's four people with six battles, so they're rather basic. They're really nothing to really worry about. Also, I gave Anastasia the really... I don't know. This is how far I got, and I got stuck, and I was like, oh, because I can't escape. Does she have crests? I didn't check. Because there was two saves. One was at like 32 minutes, one was at 35. And I'm kind of worried. Oh no, I'm fine. Alright. Because I gave her Gale Crest, which causes delay and slowdown, I believe. And Rock Crest, which decreases physical defense. And since I'm usually running around with Yuri, who's a powerhouse, Karando, who has basically the highest attack value in the game, and Karen, who's balanced, but I usually end up using her physical abilities anyway. So, that makes sense. Anyway, as you can see, we have Titanium Soldiers, and they are going to get their rocks. Something, something, something. Yeah, they're going to die horribly. Yes, it feels, maybe it's, it might be part of my TV, doesn't show it as quickly. It might be the fact that it's less fuzzy, but the timing feels a little bit different for me, so there might be some failage. And this is why, you know, I gave her the physical defense thing, because usually these guys combo and blah blah blah. Now I gotta deal with so slow, but anyways, I will meet you after this is dead. Anyway, those are dead. I still need to get used to the whole different... Yeah, I'm gonna stop complaining about that now. It just sounds like an excuse. Anyways, we got Lava Lumps and Samurai Ghouls, but I can deal with those quite nicely. This won't kill the Lava Lump, but it'd probably kill the Samurai Ghoul. But yes, I'll meet you after this one as well. And those are dead. Well, one more comment. It's kind of strange that I had such a bad TV and I got used to playing with that, and it gives me a good TV and I kind of trip up here and there. But yeah, I actually get to fight Raiden, which isn't really a big deal. All he does is physical attack and cast anti-armor bomb, which is not really threatening at all. Yeah, definitely not. And yes, I'll meet you after this as well. What is he based? Yeah, he's Earth-based. Gilcrest time! Ha ha! And Raiden's been defeated. Well, how do you like I'm kind of interested now to see what all the lettering on the little platform says. I know it says Terra somewhere on it, like right there. Anyways, got another Samurai Ghoul and a Scorpilus. Let's get rid of the Samurai Ghoul first, but yeah, also, don't these guys cast poison? I think they do, and that's why I wanted the crucifix, but it doesn't really matter. I will meet you after this as well. Oh my god, look at how many turns I get. That's funny. So yeah, he's susceptible to Gilcrest. And that group's dead. Yay. Next trial start. How many fights have I been in so far? I know we need to fight, this dude. I think there's one more dude after him, though. I believe he's wind-based, though. He is kind of fast. I might want to try Gilcrest on him simply for the fact of trying to slow him down. But anyway, I'll meet you after the fight's done, and I'll show anything interesting that happens. And that dude's been beaten. Any more? Yeah, I think this is the last one, though. And I get to fight the Great Gamma. Oh, he's gonna get beaten up by a little girl. I believe this is his 7th key edition. I believe so. I'm pretty sure. But, actually, you know what? I'm gonna gale myself, too. Why not? But yeah, I'll meet you after this is done as well. And the Great Gamma's been defeated. By Gale Spin, no less. Because I ran Anastasia completely dry on MP. Trial complete. Perfect timing, so I don't have to use a pure extract, and I can use a tent. Which is far, far cheaper. Here's a reward, blah blah blah, Dark Angel, that's what, the SP maximum increasing one that I'm not going to use? Yeah, it's that one. It sounds good on paper, but in actual practice, I guess it's not as nice. But, let's save. Just because... I had actually finished it, but, stuff happens. Come on. Alright, let's do the other one. That's remaining. And next time I'll be doing whatever's left. Make sure I do this right, because the other time I did this, I put Yuri all the way to the left, and I'm like, derp. That was dumb. It didn't stop me from completing it. It's just one of the fact of, oh, oops, just little dumb things that you do by accident. And we get a couple of toads, which are going to get pretty much pwned. Oh, it's... I didn't take off the thing? Anyway. Yeah. Get the, Dark Seraphon and Druiden are actually 7, not 8. But, you know, I guess rounds up when it's, halves. But yes! And those two dudes are dead. Didn't take long, let me tell you. Especially with For the Child followed by Euthanasia. Kind of makes the fights pretty short. Blooming Phoenix, that's not even bad. I might as well just, you know, turn into Libertas and call it a day. Gathering, boom, they're all dead. Yeah. And that's another group dead. Tsukiyomi, just for the fact of Tsukiyomi can hit multiple characters, and Juden really can't. At least both of his fusions remain useful. Really? More titanium soldiers? Yeah, you know it's coming. Alright, I am sick of seeing titanium soldiers. Let me tell ya. Kind of not even worth fighting. Even in a trial, they're not worth fighting. Oh no, this is the guy immune to physical damage, isn't he? Crap. That's all I gotta say is just crap. This is going to take a... Now I remember why that part was so long. That, as far as the recorded piece, the recorded... I ended up with like 45 minutes. But the recorded part was just absurdly long. Yeah, I'll meet you after this guy's dead, which is going to take about 15 minutes because, he's immune to physical damage, and I have a physical heavy team. It's going to take a while. Why didn't I just do for everyone? Durr! I am a dummy! Oh, also one thing I discovered in my previous playthrough. If you cast for everyone, then try to cast any other buffing spell, doesn't work. So the Archgale casting first might have actually helped me, but yes, anyway. Oh my god, that is a lot of turns in a row. Oh, here comes For the Child. No, he's still binded, so you can skip For the Child on Yuri's turn. So it's until the character's next turn then. Alright. On the enemy's next turn anyway. Yeah, I'm up to 43. Alright, that guy's finally dead. There was some goofing around and failing at rings, but, whatever. How dare you even think about attacking me? Ugh, next trial. That took too long. But then again, yeah. And just some normal dudes that aren't really threatening at all. Yes. Yep, one move. They're dead. Guess I don't know. Then again, dropping For the Child on of them's rather expensive. Oh! Really? Really? I get to fight you again? He's probably going to do exactly what I think he's going to do, and Spirit Ward Yuri. Because that's what he does. Because he's a jerk. I just realized I've been doing this whole thing with Karen wearing the warning device. Durr. I am a dummy, and you don't have any MP left anyway. Blah! That's a really weird camera angle. Okay. Hi! I have a small hits combo going. Just a small one. Just tiny. It's only like 80 hits now. Wow. You're gonna sprint? Yeah, he's doing it to Yuri. Saw that coming from miles away. And he's dead. He loves to take Yuri out of this fight, like, all the time. I don't know if it's just the fact of being in certain transformations increases his chance, but it seems to do it to Yuri, like, every single time. I don't know. It's probably... Maybe it's his AI. That's what I'm thinking. Electroban. It's another thing for our resident, very large, bodybuilding, wrestling, vampire man. I believe this increases the frequency of... Yeah. It makes it easier to turn in the great question. Kind of curious. Wow. I wonder... We'll change into Golden Bat in three more battles. Actually, if I give him one of his, well, the Golden Bat one, maybe? Actually, no, the frequency would be way too high. Where is it? I can't find it. Am I blind? Have I gone by it like 6 times already? The hell? Okay, it's not just me. It's not here, right? Oh, I can only put on one of them. Alright, that makes a lot more sense. Yeah, I'm not... Because there's actually a fight. Now that we've done those, we can talk to her again. She's going to say that we have a new one to do. But you're supposed to bring Yokim or do something else to kill one of the enemies in it, because they are immune to everything. But Petrify and Drain Touch. Sadly, I don't have my original recording, which actually shows my reaction to getting my butt kicked in the last round. Because I didn't have any of that prepared. I didn't know it, so... Sadly, you lose out on that, but... And I'm gonna do that next time, anyway. If you keep that up, there will be more! Okay, fine, I'll do it! Yes, Sarah's a bit of a odd duck. No, let's not, so I can save, and next time, we will do that. Of course, I'm going to save in the interim. But, until then, this is RPG Looney, signing off. Until then.